Following here, a truck driver accused of causing a crash that killed three people last year agrees to a plea deal, but mentally ill. Bruce Pollard is charged with three counts of reckless homicide in the crash on 465 that killed a mom and her twin babies. Fox 59's Jesse Wells has been following this case every step of the way. He's live in the studio now with exclusive details on this plea deal.
Well, the suspect's mental health has been a question from the moment he was arrested. According to court records, Bruce Pollard initially showed no remorse for killing three people. Yet one legal expert says a plea of guilty but mentally ill will hold the 57-year-old accountable for the deaths.
Feel bad about what happened?
Yes, sir.
Come on, keep walking, man. Keep walking.
Walking to court for the first time last year, Bruce Pollard expressed some regret for causing the deaths of 29-year-old Alana Coons and her 18-month-old twins, June and Ruby. The mother and toddlers were killed in their car on 465 last July when prosecutors say Pollard, while behind the wheel of his semi-truck, got distracted, reaching for iced tea and crashed into them. Prosecutors claim Pollard didn't notice traffic had slowed for construction and caused the chain reaction crash. Last year, Pollard's attorney filed this motion seeking a psychiatric exam after claiming his client showed signs of mental illness.
That he continues to ask for his mom. He acts almost childlike. He says, am I going to get the chair? I've assured him we don't have a chair anymore, electric chair in Indiana.
While doctors eventually ruled Pollard competent to stand trial for reckless homicide, a plea agreement now calls for the Missouri truck driver to be sentenced to 3 to 9 years in state custody.
It seemed to me that all parties are in agreement that this person does have some issues.
Attorney Jeff Mendes isn't connected to Pollard's case, but explains that by pleading guilty but mentally ill, Pollard will get psychiatric treatment and will not be released until he serves his full punishment.
A lot of people are under a misunderstanding that if you plead guilty to a crime, and you're pleading but mentally ill, a lot of people perceive that as being, well, they're going to get some treatment for a year or two, and then they're going to be released. That is absolutely not the case.
Now, finally, while the plea deal has been signed by the defense and the prosecution, ultimately the judge in the case does have the final approval. Today, both the prosecutors and the Coons family did not want to comment on the deal. Back to you.
All right, Jesse, thank you.